Brevan Howard Asset Management is looking at about $1 billion of client withdrawals just this month.
That's right.
But he doesn't want to bail yet.
No, it's really interesting. I mean, this is a guy, this is the most read story in the Bloomberg this morning, as you might imagine, because, you know, Alan Howard is a legendary figure. He's a billionaire. And this is also not a story that sort of stands alone. This is obviously about him, but it's also about the whole industry and the hedge fund industry. Really, the word you use and the word we use in the story is rebooting. And the numbers for him are pretty staggering. So you mentioned $1 billion. That's on top of $5.4 billion that's been pulled so far this year. So,
and overall, just take a look at that chart. Three quarters has been drawn out since its $40 billion peak. I mean, that's a chart that no manager wants to be
no manager and no client wants to see that either.
Yeah, really.
We've seen this story already though with others. I mean, Bluecrest certainly has seen their assets under management go down quite a bit. I think that what's interesting about this is that this is not an equity long short kind of fund, which potentially for clients could be more understandable. This is a macro strategy, and that is less forgivable.
Right,
and
you need to be winning in a market like this.
Exactly,
right? This is a cool bull market we're in the midst of.
I want to bring to you what Mark Lazary, the co-founder of Avenue Capital, said about this. He said, quote, in a benign environment like we've been in, it's hard to outperform the market. No kidding. Right now, what the investing world offers you is niches. And to find these opportunities, you need a big team. This is direct lending. This is esoteric stuff. This is your legal settlements. This is your et cetera. Really interesting. This trend of bigger firms will become more pronounced, so will requiring longer lockups for investors. Again, back to those sort of illiquid assets.
Right.
That are going to require these.
Well, and what we're hearing from Alan Howard, and this is a great story that really goes in depth into this, is that, you know, he's going to start trying some new things. He's creating a new fund that's going to allow him himself to take a few more risks. He's getting into AI. I know that's something that we've talked about quite a bit as well.
But what's interesting, though, I was talking to some bankers earlier in the week, and they were basically saying that their biggest worry is those passive ETFs, because we wind up seeing dispersion within stocks in the S&P going down. It should be good, though, for stock pickers, not necessarily macro, but stock pickers. At the same time, we have the passive money and ETFs keep picking up. And that's a scary thought when you have hedge fund managers having to close down or reboot.
Right. And as we sort of alluded to before, I mean, the names of people who have either had bad years or have closed down, I mean, these are really well known. Druckenmiller, terrible year. You know, John Burbank closing Passport. Neil Chris closing Hutch & Hill. I mean, that's kind of it's quite a time in the hedge fund industry.